Yo, today I'll show you how to make a pigment with dandelions. I'll share some fun facts about the flowers, talk about when and how to harvest them, how to extract their colors, bubbles, and getting the pigment ready for future use in paints or more. All of that while having the hiccups. I present to you the Beelover pigment. Chickens are cool. Here's some dandelions. Like many people where I live here in Quebec, I have tons of them around my house. So seeing this abundance and accessibility, I wondered, what if I could like make paint with it or something? So I took a fresh flower and just tried rubbing it on a paper just to see if it would do something. And the more I rubbed it, the deeper the color got. That was a good sign. I did the same thing with the leaves of the dandelions by curiosity. And oh yeah, I was into something pretty promising. Growing up here, I kept being told that dandelions were bad. All my life I've been seeing my parents and neighbors fighting to kill dandelions and try chasing them from the lands around. So I want to make a special parenthesis that is very important about dandelions. And as a certified wildlife technician, trust me, I know what I'm talking about. I studied bees for a year and a half in school. Bees are literally the reason why we can eat because of their pollinating skills. And that's where the dandelion comes in. Dandelions are super important. They are some of the first flowers to open in spring, which makes them very valuable because they serve as the main food supply for the bees and their newborns after hibernation. And as dandelions are present in great quantities, they really help to keep them bees alive. So for all of the dandelions haters out there, please double think it. And please don't take them out of the ground. And for all the dandelions lovers out there, spread the love and spread the knowledge. Bees really need them, and we really need bees. So, knowing this and wanting to make pigments out of dandelions, the best time to harvest them is at the end of their cycle, right before they turn into that white fluffy thing. That way, they had properly served bees, and at that time of the cycle, it also means that new species of flowers are now opened, so there's way more abundance of food for the bees than there were in the beginning of the spring. So now, picking time. Picking time! I brought a bowl with me and started harvesting. All I need from the flowers are the petals, so I took the bud and detached the petals by putting pressure on the bud and pulling the petals while making like a twist movement. I don't know if it's only because of the good timing, like the fact that it's the end of the cycle of the flower, but that was so easy. Look at that yellow on my hand. This means the flower is very rich in pigments. I found an even better technique. Instead of picking the bud, I tried leaving the plant whole and pick the petals directly. It went even better and faster and was way more satisfying. I prefer that technique. Here's my sweet harvest. And I sneaked without the camera to pick up some leaves on the white fluffy ones. Cool contrast. Alright, let's warm those babies up and get the color out. I put all the petals in the pan and then add enough water to completely submerge them. Little note here, it's good to know the exact quantity of liquids added. It will serve later when making the lake pigment. And then I put the fire at simmer and let it there for 30 to 60 minutes. I've never tried this with dandelions, but I've tried it with other plants. And what you can do is, When you take it out of the fire, you can leave everything in a pot and let that cool down for a whole night, until the next day. This process is supposed to help deepen the color. But, little warning, sometimes it also can weaken the color or change the color. It really depends on the plant. But if you have time and feel like experimenting, go for it. And tell me about it in the comments. I'd love to hear about it. Okay, so then I filter the organic material just to keep the clean yellow water. And try to extract as much as I can by squeezing the petals real hard to end up with this curious structure. Let's just...
Tu dis un réflexe? C'est weird, hein?
Just réflexe.
Okay, so now next step, the bubbles, aka precipitation, aka lake pigment. For that, the water has to be warm or it won't work. So for the pigment to separate from the water, we need to add two ingredients. First, alum. Proportion is 10 grams per liter. I read it's better to weigh it than measure it. Okay, now we don't necessarily have to do that, because I've been doing it like right away putting the next ingredient in, but I have heard from the Alchemical Arts YouTube guy that it has better effect if we wait 30 minutes and then add the other ingredient, sodium carbonate. 5 grams per liter. Yeah, look at those bubbles. That's what we're looking for. By the way, don't do that in a small container. The bubbles will spread everywhere. I always do it in a big pan. And yeah, mixing is very important too, so that everything blends together, so that the magic can happen. So, normally you don't have to transfer it into a transparent jar, but I do it to show you what's happening in here. Slowly, the pigment is detaching from the water and getting down at the bottom. It takes a few minutes. Alright, we'll let that sit for a while and repeat the steps with the dandelion leaves. And you should definitely watch this and not skip it, because satisfying entertainment, and because if you're a pigment beginner, then repetition always pays, knowledgely speaking. Alright, new pan. Can I do this with my hands? No, I can't. Usually smaller pieces is better, but my grass-cutting patience reaches a certain degree. Let's not waste any peas, and back to the pan. We put the leaves in there and cover them with water, taking notes of the amount of water added, and simmer that for 30 to 60 minutes or more or less. You're the boss. Let's look at that color. Well, not much different from the flowers or what? Okay, we strain that, we make sure the water is warm, and we put alum, 10 grams per liter, mix and mix and mix and mix, and wait 30 minutes, then add sodium carbonate, 5 grams per liter, then cool bubbles, and mix and mix and mix and mix and mix. And let's put that in a jar too to look at the pigment separation and compare the colors of the leaves and the flowers of the dandelion. Well, both seem pretty yellow to me. Okay, now we need to isolate that pigment, so we'll get rid of the clear water on top, because there's actually no pigment in there. We pour it down until we see like a little dark yellow particle reaching for the outside. We want to let that little particle in. Sometimes I drop a little. Whoops! And now filter time! Some people use coffee filter, but I always get pieces of paper in my pigment using coffee filters. Plus, it's trashed after, so I make a washable one by cutting a piece of fabric and putting it on top of a deep or slash large enough bowl. I attach it with clips and pour the leftover water with the pigment inside down the fabric. That will make all the water be filtered and drained out of the pigment. After a few hours, there will be only the pigment left in the fabric, and it's gonna be looking like a kind of paste. We could use that straight away if we were making water-based paint, but now we only want a pigment, so we'll wait and let it dry there for a while. I like detaching the fabric from the ball, so I don't let the water in there humidify the pigment, and then I can empty the water and use the ball. So here's day one. Day two, it starts making like cracks. That's good. And then day three, it's all dry and ready for our next step. Look at that texture. So ready. Okay, I want to share with you a really sad story about this step of pigment making, like when we filter the pigment. So before winter, I was picking up fall leaves and it gave me like a beautiful brownish and orangey pigment, and I was so thrilled. And I was like having like a lot of pigment, like it was maybe 4 or 5 times the amount of this dandelion pigment we're making. And so I filtered it and let it all in one fabric, thinking that it was gonna dry. I don't know like what went into my mind at that time, but I didn't really think far, because a few days later what appeared in there was like a bunch of mold. So I lost all this pigment, and it was a really good lesson for me, and I hope it's gonna be a lesson for you, that if you have like a big amount of pigment and like a thick layer when you put it on the fabric, like when you strain it in the fabric, it's way better to separate it in different fabrics so that it's gonna be like a thinner layer and dry properly. So please don't do the same mistake as me and spread your pigment. So I like using a scraper for this one, and I scrap all the pigment down so it detaches from the fabric. This is satisfying. I repeat that for the leaf pigment and bring it to our friend, the coffee grinder. Look at the fabric, how the flower pigment colored it. So pigment is in here, and very important to put a convenient mask for this step, because you don't want dust in your lungs. Dust in lungs is not good. Any kind of dust. And go coffee grinder go! A good 2 minutes grind usually does a great job. When it forms like a little dust on top, it means it's fine enough. So now what you shouldn't do is to open the grinder right away. That would put dust all around, and what did we say before? Any kind of dust is bad for the lungs. So we leave that grinder closed for a few minutes and wait that it settles down to open it. Yeah, our pigment is ready. I put a funnel in there because it would suck to make a mess and waste some of our precious pigment. So precious, I even take a paintbrush to go collect all the leftover pigment in there. And here's the final product from the dandelion petals. Now the dandelion leaves pigment. The fabric is a bit less dark for this one. And we grind it up. Look at that. Scoop it up, and there you go, the dandelion leaf pigment. I would say a bit darker than the petals. It's subtle, but the difference is there. And now I make sure to identify them well. Please do it, don't underestimate the step. You will thank yourself later. And here we go, our two dandelions flowers and leaves pigment. Now pop that top open for 10 days because there's still humidity in there and it needs to get out for a good preservation purpose. By the way, the container I use here is not optimal. It's way too big. A smaller container with less air between the pigment and the top is the best. Go check out my other videos where I make fabric paint with this sweet dandelion flower pigment and more. Stay tuned and good creations. Ciao!